Thank you very much, Dean Garrett. And congratulations, Marshall School of Business, class of 2023. Very exciting. I have 5 minutes to get to the point, and so let me get there quickly. Your life is going to change radically. Now, don't roll your eyes. You probably think, oh, they always say that at graduations. It is true, you are leaving the safety net of USC for the real world. But something else is going on. You are graduating into a world of the most radical change and transformation in history. I have been in the business, the financial world, for 43 years. And in those 43 years, I've seen a lot of change. I saw the PC, well, first of all, the PC, the cellular phone, the internet. Wow, those are going to look quaint compared to what's going to happen. Now, that was 43 years compared to what's going to happen in the next 5 to 10 years. now, what's great about this is this is presenting amazing opportunities for you, because in my world, many people do not believe the statement I just said. They just don't believe change will happen that quickly. Last time they heard about exponential growth, it was in the tech and telecom bubble, and that ended badly. So everyone's scared. You are going to be the movers and shakers of the 5 major platforms that Dean Garrett mentioned. And you're also going to watch them converge. What robots and energy storage and artificial intelligence, how are they going to converge? They're going to converge into autonomous taxi platforms that are going to create $8 to $10 trillion in revenue by the year 2030 versus zero now. The financial opportunities are amazing. Right now, truly disruptive innovation in the public and private equity markets are valued at about $13 trillion, a little bit more than 10% of all equity market valuations globally. We believe that number is going to scale 40% at a compound annual rate between now and 2030. And it is because of those 5 platforms and the convergences between and among those platforms. Just to give you a sense of what this means, right now, truly disruptive innovation represents about a half of GDP. If you measure it, it's valued in the marketplace at half of US GDP. In 7 to 10 years, it's going to be 10 times the size of our economy. Wealth creation opportunities coming out of disruptive innovation. And you're going to be at the vanguard. Now, this is tremendous opportunity, but with it comes risk, because disruptive innovation means disturbing the traditional world order, creative destruction. And we believe every sector, every industry, every company is going to be disrupted. Now, how do you get on the right side of change? Well, first of all, you got a great education here. And in a school now that Dean Garrett is leading that is focused on disruptive innovation, technological change, and how it's going to transform the world. So you are, Marshall School has pointed you in the right direction to the right companies. These companies have sought you out. But here are some do's and don'ts, and I'll start with the don'ts before we end with the do's. Don't assume that great brands and great management teams today understand what is about to happen. You actually might understand more than they do. And the best thing you could do out there is make your boss look brilliant, because you probably know more about the technological revolution that's going to disrupt than he does. There are 2 companies, Google and FTX. You know, a year ago, you would have thought these companies can't lose. And now ChatGPT is a risk to Google. It's probably it could be the worst thing or the best thing to happen to Google, to really light a fire under it. FTX went very badly, but guess what? That proved the concept. truly decentralized, transparent blockchain networks are the way the world will evolve. FTX was completely centralized, opaque, and unfortunately fraudulent. What is the to-do? The to-do is first, keep educating yourself. This world is moving so quickly, just keep, follow your passion, keep educating yourselves. And there are a lot of ways to do that outside of the university system. Also very important, listen to that voice inside of you. Listen to that voice. Some people call this voice the force, or the universe, or God, or in my case, the Holy Spirit. That voice is telling you the path you were meant to travel, and will also tell you when you're off of it. And so you must make sure that you're still on the right path. Meditate, pray, trust, but verify. Meditate, pray. And so the right question during those moments to ask is, am I still on the right path, or should I pivot, as Naomi said, on the right, to get back on the right side of change? So go for it. Fight on. Congratulations.